Welcome, 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 YouTubers, to another Dancing Clear interview. Just big up yourself, Dancing Clear. I'll be your host today, Shawnee T, right? So, people, it's been a minute since you've seen us, right? It's been a minute since we had one of them great conversations, all right? So, because it's been so long, we came back with an in-depth conversation. We came back with knowledge and an insight into the culture that we all love. So, to my left, please introduce yourself.
My name is Metro. Everybody call me Metro. The sound system that I use to, the sound system that I build. But the right name for it is Metro Downbeat. It's Tune Weaver. Originate 1958 at 31 Glenham Road, Clapton.
So, Mitchell, let me just start from the top. What year did you come to England?
I came in 56.
Okay.
Two months from the 56 finish. Mm-hmm. So I don't bother calling, so I don't need to tell people that I come here 57. You know? But actually, I left Jamaica 56. When I came here, you know, I went to Nottingham, Fleet Street. Number 8, Fleet Street. The front door is at the back of the house. Them time was a treacherous time. When I say cold, I can't explain it because if you should actually have your hand plus all ways of gloves, it's not a matter, it's compulsory, you have to have gloves. And if you take out your hand out of your pocket with that gloves and put it outside, you have a frostbite instant. So it was really terrible, you know.
Yeah.
So I landed in Nottingham with my relation and cousins and wanting, because they were here before me. When since I had a big brother, he came here from 52. Over the years, my school years, he always sent him to me, asking me to get records, certain records that he actually remembered that he left in Jamaica.
Okay.
Well, it's all that I found myself in an opportunity that Tom the Great Sebastian, he was before Duke Reed, and he was number one at them time. Mm-hmm. Right? So Tom took the song from off the street. It wasn't mobile anymore. He took it to the Silver Sipper Club, and he started to play in the Silver Sipper Club. 24 hours that club opened.
Wow.
And if you come up at halfway tree and you're actually on the other side of Carib Theatre, you can hear the sound beating from over the club.
So it's a big sound then?
I said number one, you were number one.
But I said, I
not
that's number one in popularity, but I say as a big
sound
system with
them time when the sound in Jamaica, the earth started to move behind it, you know?
Yeah.
Strong background. Mm-hmm. Some of them were distorted.
Yeah.
Very distorted. But at them time people are listening for those kind of things. They just want to hear the record, you know?
Yeah.
And at the time when we were 78 record, a lot of them have a lot of issues and them, nobody care all about that.
Yeah.
You know, but people enjoy themselves. Because that was the thing that going on in Jamaica at that time. That was our livelihood. Every Jamaican, rhythm and blues, they break it back down to rock and roll and soul and all these kind of things.
Mm-hmm.
But Jamaican people love these type of music.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So I remember when I left Jamaica, they wouldn't know reggae exists.
Okay.
Right? I start sound system. When I do start sound system here, my elder brother said to me, say, it's not gonna work. Because where I'm gonna play this music. I would say a lot of people don't seem like all they are the radiogram and things like that. And anyway, I was looking for an amplifier that can satisfy me. Because what I wanted him from Jamaica, because I had that intention. You know what I mean? Because they say, my sound half better than Duke Reed. Alright?
Is Duke Reed,
it's so obvious that it come from his own mouth. Coxson come from his own, left Jamaica and come up here and listen my thing there and compliment. Coxson came up and said to me that he called Jackson. He said to the old man and said to me, said, Jackson, well, yeah, one of the heaviest sound of the world, you know. But I take, you know, I just take it for granted. Because, but you see, the memory, what I left in Jamaica, you know, there's something that, there's a drawback between me and that thing, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I insist on my brother because, I mean, I just come from Jamaica. We don't have no money. Because people wonder, say, well, then, you come here 56, right? And spend nearly 11 months in Nottingham. Came down to my brother, because when I wrote him and told him that I was in Nottingham, you know the exact way he writes, but a little piece of paper. But the rest class he had done in Nottingham. Right? And he sent me £15.
Okay. That's a lot of money in them time.
£15?
Mm-hmm.
That's 2-3 weeks we had this man.
Yeah.
Right? And he explained to me that he'd take the train and come down and things like that. The friend that caused me to come to England, his name is Joe, right? That's another part of the story. It takes a long time, which I explained that in the book. Yeah.
Okay.
Because he is the one that caused me. Because when I say a true friend, who grew up as childhood days, and anything is him or me. You understand?
Yeah.
And he found himself in that position, you know what I mean? And because he was working for this man. I don't want to record that, you know. And the wife fell in love with him. Trust me. Truth I'm telling you. Right? And this man is a big celebrity in Jamaica. Because this man worked millions. Yeah, and I experienced something like that. And when the secret started to break, we went one night to same character theater to see what I knew. And when we left my home, it was only two of us, it was a truck, but it was passing two people can hold in the chopper. You can put three, but you have to sit down above Bonville Sea. And we went for a picnic this Sunday, right? Well, the young girls, them and things like that. Because they one of them, you know, the back of the chuck and things like that, and making noise and things like that. They used to have a thing they call pedal pushers with the girl them wear and things like that. So we decided, so we have this picnic. Joe's uncle planned the picnic. And it was like this place consists of a lot of banana, all the citrus they know. All the citrus where exists in Jamaica, he have it on that farm. Mm-hmm. So he actually decided to make a picnic, so all of us went down there. So while we were down the river having a bath and things like that, you know, Joe turned and said to me, the morning was warm, you know, it was Sunday morning.
Yeah.
He said to me, we're going to look a couple of coconut. It was about nearly 40 or 50 people in the river. Because a wide, wide, deep place.
Yeah.
Everybody was gallivanting and bathing and things like that. And the boat was just come out in our bathroom. Our clothes left the same place on the shore. And we walk up to the property. And it's somewhat like John Lee in the story. He look up and he says, some nice coconut there. Right?
Yeah.
Remember, he's just coming out of the river, you know?
Yeah.
And up here naked, all him up was just the chunk.
Yeah.
And he started to climb the coconut tree. When he climbed the coconut tree and go up now, when I observed and look, I saw one coconut limb. Because you could see that coconut tree. Nobody disturbed it for years because it has some lovely coconuts on it, right? So this limb hung down like that to the coconut, but it wasn't time for it to loose from the tree.
Yeah.
And when I saw Joe was off the coconut tree going up, someone said to him, mind that coconut limb, you know, mind your whole arm on it and it dropped like it. And he climbed until he reached the arch where his hand could actually touch the coconut. And I stood there watching. Nobody knew that the boat was up there, right? So actually, when he decided to pick the coconut, we were going to pick the coconut there and carry them down on the river. And get the girls them a surprise, you know what I mean? Somehow this guy saw us when in the property, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And he walked behind, but I didn't see him. Right? And I'm telling you, before Joe could put him on pan one of the coconuts to turn it like that to break it. The limb were hung down like that. There was a wasp nest there.
Wow.
And the wasp him start on him and him just let go. The man dropped about. I can't feel. But when he really drops, there's one stone like a tomb.
Oh.
Another one there. And it was a place that people molesting and you see tracks and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of water grass grow between the two stones.
Okay.
And that's where he jumped on. So the guy was behind me now, right?
Mm-hmm.
He saw everything, so he just turned back and run, go down to the river side and tell everybody, say, Joe, jump off of the coconut tree. And the whole posse was there.
Mm-hmm.
When I come, he's still unconscious, down on the ground.
Okay.
But nobody would go near him. My people, just girls, they must scream and make him holy and nice and all them kind of thing. So it was friend, I'm gonna it was like a dream to me.
Yeah.
So I just got on and I said, Joe, and I shake him, I shake him. No response. I do it about 8 times continuously. No response. And when the crowd saw me do that, right, everybody started to run back and screaming. Because they say he's dead.
Dead, yeah.
You understand? So, when I realized it was only 2 of us left there, so they run around to the house where we're carrying goat meat and all them kind of things there, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And it was a little picnic, you know what I mean?
Yes.
So the uncle run and came around. So just as the uncle came back, I could saw him coming, and I make a retract back down, draw line down there.
Yeah.
So I said, nah, man. I said to myself, he can't dead. He can't dead. I went down, you know, and I shout in them ears. Can you hear them like that, right?
Yeah.
Shout and I said, Joe! And no response. So when I look at his bathroom, and when I looked down there, it was totally red.
Yeah.
But the water grass, there are red water grass.
Okay.
So when it dropped on the water grass, it crushed and looked like blood.
Oh,
well. You understand?
Yeah, yeah.
So I said, when I shout, I'm shaking, I said, Joe, you can't, what more do you, man? I said, get up, now, man. I'm going to turn on you like that. I'm going to hear somebody go, huh? And that was Joe. Like he jumped out of his sleep.
Okay.
All right. So I said, all right, Joe. And listen to me. When we check him out, he doesn't have a scratch. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But what was happening now, the man that he works for, he got involved with a woman,
mm-hmm.
right? Secretly. The wife, you know.
Yeah?
Yeah, man, I thought you make a millionaire, man, you know, name mm-hmm. Shivans.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to Jamaica and come off a stone here, he's the man who's greater in the road, all over the island of Jamaica.
Okay.
He's not a small fish, he's a big boy.
Yeah.
Right? Right? Stores in Princeton, they have stores out there. And they have quite a few daughters and things like that. You know? And the wife could be Joe's mother. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, they're really unique one, them nice. Because she's more like a Syrian woman. And, well, them things they never had too long. The man heard about it. Right? So I don't tell you about what happened to me and him now. How I come, that he's the reason why I'm in England.
Okay.
Because I could come to England through my brother, correspondent and record.
Yeah.
Okay? But my brother sent me £15 to buy record from, you know, play the car 1 ounce. That's what we pay. Could I get 78 records to buy?
Mm-hmm.
You never have a lot of record shop in Jamaica. You know?
The
rhythm and blues.
Yeah.
Because it's an import product. You know?
Yeah.
So they have to get it from America and sell it. Seems like all the, we are doing here.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway. When him drop off of the tree, right, that's when I gonna find out the problem. Right? Because some nice girl was there, but you're never interested in a little of them. You want them, we have at a picnic, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You know? So uptime we revive and come up, I said to him, so what are you going to do now? So he said, I'm going to go back. And then go back to the place where I'm currently going. So I said, anyway, I'll go, man, we'll go with you. There you go. I would draw from there and come. Where I'm living in Jamaica, my people run the Castleton Garden, the Botanical Garden.
Yeah.
When every sound system that goes to play in that garden, every Sunday, Saturday, Friday, sound system is all over there.
Metro, tell me about some of the great sound systems that played there. Yeah, you can remember the names of the great sound
well,
systems.
Well, at that time, you have Nick, you have Roderick, Tom, the great Sebastian, Blue Mirror, Coxson, Fire, they come from Four Roads.
Okay.
It was a massive, the first time me see also drive back, right? With two speakers in there, but them speakers, you know, the touring speaker.
Mm-hmm.
You see, that's why a lot of people don't realize in those years. You never have 18-inch speaker. You could have gone buy 18-inch speaker, you know.
Okay.
Right? The largest speaker was Voltavox. And they were Enfield, 15-inch.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The first 15-inch speaker that Goodman made, a man named Mr. Lampkin, make it for me. Because I rode a bicycle. Right? Straight to Wembley, because when I reached I couldn't even find the factory. Right? And one man said, you remember when Henry Cooper and Cassius Clay had that fight? When Cassius take out the whole Enfield. Right? Because when I went in the shop, they have the plaster and everything on his face, you know?
Yeah.
Because I was even scared for the heart to many questions to a black man, you know.
Okay.
You know? So I went inside and I asked him, said, where can I find a good man speaker? And he took a pencil and he drew a map with a road and things like that. A bicycle, my ride, you know. So I found it. Right? So I went inside there and ask questions, you know, I want the man who designed the speaker then. And when this man came out, he was hip-shotted, like, you know, he was walking, you know, 1 foot taller than that one. What is happening at the war? The man named Mr. Lampkin. He was the founder of a Goodman speaker, right? So when I asked him about the speaker, he said, Where you going to use it? So I said, we run a sound system. He said, sound system? What's that? I said, it's a sound system. I think that's it. So I started to explain. Then eventually, when men are getting now, him find out what the full details are.
Yeah.
Right? So he said, but we don't have the authority to build 15-inch speaker. The company, you know, give them the authorize them to do it. So I leave and I come back home. But I gave him my address, full details and everything. We had a phone inside of the hallway of the house. Because the house that we're living in, like one family.
Yeah.
We're not family, but boys and girls, everybody just unite, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You know? If one of them say I read, everybody I say I read. That's how they used to live.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I came back and But I came on this amplifier. A little general turntable, because I got the amplifier from a man named Tiny from Dawson, right? Because the rest of things them what was selling, they are 25 watt. I tell them something, I don't believe them. Most of these guys who had these things there, he start to play from 6 o'clock in the evening and buy 11 o'clock, that amplifier catch a fire.
Okay.
Because when I discovered it built, it didn't have like a resistant choke, and then I use a big resistor. And the more you drive it, the resistor starts to draw current and start to get hot.
Yeah.
Right? So anything that gets overheated must deteriorate, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that was the problem. You know? But I didn't go down that low.
How did you overcome that?
Yes, my thing there was, I was looking for 100 watts. Because 100 watts amplifier, you ask a man for, because you could have cocks them in Jamaica, then if you ask them about, they don't know nothing about that. But there's a disguise in Jamaica. Now the big arms them, right? They used to use them, so that arm show the sound a distance. But low frequency, no.
No bass wise.
You understand? Because if you even have it, you have nothing to introduce it to. Because the speaker them is 15 watt, 25 watt. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So what the next thing, what they get away through the rhythm and blues doesn't have that bass frequency. You know, you play up the scale, boom, 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 you know?
Mm-hmm.
So you'll find that they're fascinating with that kind of sound. But in England now, when I get my amplifier from Tiny, I didn't have any box. But the first trade that I learned here, right? The first trade that I learned here was, you see that? These? Lamination thing here?
Yeah.
You see the veneer where they're planted?
Mm-hmm.
It's about 2 or 3 pieces of veneer. I learned that to do that on a machine. Tape it and join it. When you join it, it's supposed to look like this. But there's a mark in a line, you know. That is a big trade, man. Got it going in for like top class furniture. I mean, learned that in Wells Street.
In Hackney? No.
Mm-hmm. Mm. So, while I was there one day, they brought in some veneer, sir. You know, they brought in some veneer. The man, I can't forget his name, is Vic. He drive one of these Bedford truck, but nobody had it. So they just put the slab in, like me having a slab. I don't know the idea, you know, because when I see it and look at the mirror and the wood them and the width of them and the length of it, I say, them are furniture, this is the kind of wood that Jamaica man make some dangerous furniture out of it.
Yeah.
So when I look at them, I say, but I can't make a box, man, speaker box. You don't have to join up nothing, because back home now, the man used to join the words them together.
Yeah.
So you find some, when you play, when the bass free, it open the join them.
Alright.
You know? And you get bam, 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 bam. Nasty sound.
Mm.
Yeah, that's what I said. People never mind about that. You only want to hear music I play. You just enjoy himself, you know? So, but I said to myself, I can make I make box, man. So my girl, Daniel, said to Vic, say, Vic, where do you do a slab? Vic said, I just dump them somewhere, man. Them time I used to do a lot of dumping. Yeah. You know, drive out on the road and just walk the back of it. And
it's the fit, you know? Yeah.
So I said to him, say, you can't get me out. Because two of them can make 4 hours of drive back. Because the length of it.
Mm.
So I said, two of that door.
Okay.
The length.
Yeah,
the width, actually, about even about the same size of the door.
Yeah.
The width of it.
Yeah.
Right? So that means so then, all you have to do, cut out two sides, the front, top, and you have a box.
Yeah.
You understand? But you know, you're not designing it. Yeah, that's another story. So I said to Vic, say, we were living in Delano, the backyard was quite big. And I say useless, but people have inclined going around there because you still have a lot of spinach growing in the backyard. So I'm telling you, I said to Vic, say, how much you charge? Vic said, ah, oh, nah, man. And he said, when you can do it, it's Saturday morning. Saturday morning, you have to end up over time to go in, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So actually, I wasn't on no overtime, you know what I mean? When I finished work, that's it. So I went down there and meet him the Saturday morning because he brought in a new load, right?
Yeah.
And I choose 4 slab. 4 slab. And he put them on the truck. And myself, my brother, and my cousin, he's in the mine named Pat. We took the slab them and put them on the back. Because we're going to get a cabinet maker now to make the box. Because the speaker, the 12-inch speaker that I had, right? Same as when I come in at the box, I just cut out a roll mold and put it down and place it in the room. You know what I mean? Trying to rehearse and all these kind of things.
Sorry, Metro, how much you pay for the speakers themselves? Like, that go inside?
The what?
The speaker that go inside of the cabinet.
Yes.
How much did you pay? How much? What is the cost of the speaker?
You mean the at them time?
Yeah.
Well, the speaker is about £5, you know. That every is somewhat. That's a 12-inch, yeah.
Okay.
Smaller speakers, remember poetry and pens. It's very, very cheap. And at the time, remember the war didn't finish, you know. And we talk about surplus equipment. If you go to Edgeway Road, Tottenham Court Road, the boat side, every shop where you, if you go down there now, and every shop that you see, they used to sell resistors and components. Because they get it from the army.
Okay.
Surplus. They used to call it surplus. It's one of one place down there used to sell a van, they call it Zen and I. Right? Because them time you never have even KT-88. You didn't have an output bottle that can supply a certain amount of current that you can get a certain amount of output. You understand? So, things were a bit, you know, limitation there,
yeah.
Right? So actually, to find that surplus power, yeah. You can make the device, but you need something that when you make the device, it's handling, and that is the speaker. The weakest link in their sound system is the speakers. Now for instance, now there's a 1,000-watt amplifier there, right? Your speaker is only 250 watts, right? When you turn on that 1,000-watt amplifier on that 250-watt, it's supposed to take the cone out of the speaker itself and throw it outside.
Yeah, too powerful.
Because the 1,000-watt is going into 250-watt, right? It's like, for instance, now you lift up something that is too heavy for you.
Yeah.
It's going to bring it right down back. Okay? So, having certain amount of power at them time, like distortion occurred because the speaker cannot angle.
So how did you overcome that situation?
Huh?
How did you overcome it?
By making a larger speaker. That's why I went to Goodman. Right? And the cone span, the wideness of it, and the circumference of it, yeah? The wider the thing is, more here. Right? And the control of the speaker, right? The resin will come off of it because when you hear it, it already reach a destination, like a boundary. When you hear the bass, you know, it already gone up in the ear and come back down because it curved like that. When I listen to the speaker go boom, it come out so. But that curve have to hit the ceiling. When you hear it down there, say, you know, it's like thunder, it's like lightning. Yeah, lightning and thunder. Because if you watch lightning and thunder, when it gets a bump, it's like something go right down to ground, go down to earth. You understand? So, but all those things that I experiment them, through my amplification and building preamps and all these kind of things.
Yeah.
But when we're saying back, like the best sound system in Jamaica at the time, because it was Duke Reed. When I say, you have other guys that, because there was a guy they called Lion Owen. He comes from Port Maria, St. Mary. Because, I mean, if you can't beat them, you join them, don't you? Now the first time Duke Reed went up to the ring, he showed Duke Reed. And from that time until this though, because the guy himself won a club, right? Duke Reed, and it was like that. And there's a lot of things that people don't even know about and read and things like that. Duke Reed, the Trojan. Now that Trojan thing there is a chuck, right? It was a chuck that Duke Reed transport the sound system. Just a small little, what you used to call them, not dilapidated, but something small, you know?
Yeah.
Look like a van, but they have a body on it like that. That chuck was belonging to the same guy I'm telling you, Liam Lydowell. Because he used to use it and draw ice from Kingston to St. Mary, right? Sometimes we make 2 trips for the day with that chuck. But he and Duke Reed, he had his own system and he gets it from him. And Duke Reed eventually take it from him and start to use it. So they just, when they write it and sign, they put Duke Reed, the Trojan. You see?
Yeah.
The chuck was the Trojan.
Okay.
You understand? Well, the chuck wasn't actually belonging to him. But Truman, this man is a close friend here. Mm-hmm. Them use it. Both of them use the same chuck, transport them sound.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But back to Reed. There's something about real sound system in Jamaica, what I really admire. Now Coxson, nothing taken away from him. But Coxson music, which you see some of those records I was playing today. That is the type of Coxson music. Because there's a beat that way. Coxson will play records like that for 4 hours with that same tempo. But he doesn't do that. Really play any record as long as somebody like it. So he have a variety of different records, you know what I mean? And he was in a position that he links up in America with some of the artists, you know? Fats Domino, Dave Bartolomeo, and all these kind of people, right? Duke Reed was with them, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So when they make any new, like how we get in Dubba Jamaica, from Dubba, man, make a tune in Dubby. That's how Duke Reed used to get the tune in. So you find Duke Reed will play a certain record that the other song in Jamaica cannot play. Right? And he will play them records for a period of time, then he just made the company release them because he used to sell records. You understand?
Mr. Mark, sorry to interrupt. So is that your kind of your biggest inspirations are in Jamaica that you brought back to England?
Yes. That
was it. So it's fair to say that you took that inspiration, you came to England,
yes.
The Bill of Sound. So yes. That was the beginning of sound system in England.
Yes.
So you're the first one to Bill of Sound in England.
Because the box about Chris on the picture. That's the first big box. The picture I'm in the box. You have it? The photograph, you know what it? Okay. Anyway. It's, like, already see that, you know?
We'll check it out. So what was kind of like, what artists did you come across at them times?
Eh?
What artists you came across in them times in
the artists?
Yeah.
No artists running about in the 50s.
Okay.
They used to call him Cubana in Bada Cuba.
Okay.
I used to hear him in all the castle and I sing with live band them, you know. Val Bennett and Baba Mota and things like that. What? You hear what I'm saying to me? It was, I can't see anything to explain it what it was like. Because you get up in the morning and you go to the little work. I leave work and come home. Next day you go to work. No, the only place you can go, you just join the people in the pub. But I don't know I really enjoy it, because, you know, if I want a drink, I buy it and go myself and drink it. You know? But that was the only enjoyment. So eventually, you know, they start to bring like, people they call Bardens, furniture people. They used him to get the radiogram. And you can take them on in higher purchase. So people used to buy that for them entertainment, you know?
So no artist, so that was you talk about the guy from Cuba. No other artists that used to come from Jamaica at them times,
When Gray and all them on the girl.
When
Gray and all these guys.
What about Bob Marley?
No, for them stories, a different story. But
okay.
We are talking about from the beginning till 61.
Okay.
Right? From that period on.
Mm-hmm.
Right? 61 when reggae start up with Busta them and all them things there. Humpy Dumpy and all these sides of record.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But Busta had a idea of Jamaica and things like that. And bring certain records because they're using the same ska music, break it down, and then people start to sing. Because there was a problem, I really said too tough. What was the recording problem in Jamaica? Pronunciation. You understand?
Yeah.
The artist pronounce. You know, I'm talking about the English territory or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
When you do the accent.
The patois.
The patois business, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And we are listening to American record and people, grammar is very great.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, come with this idea. God, me telling you, me put on a play a reggae record and people say, take off them things, them off.
Yeah.
No, I don't believe that.
Back home
in England, man.
So that's some of the struggles you used to face back then. As being
take off that the rubbish there. Yeah. A full real record, them man, I beat them, you know. But we insist. Because a sound system, well, I know of that. You introduce music to people. People introduce music to you, right? Because if you're going to do it, you must have a foundation or something. You know what I mean? So all them man put a record and take up the microphone and talk and things like that, and people stand up. They call themselves DJ. They're not rubbish. First time if you play songs, you have to have them writing people and move. And you start 6 o'clock and finish 8 o'clock a morning or 6 o'clock a morning. You can't ease up the pressure. Because
mm-hmm.
they were going. And if you're alone in there, right? We do 50 years of that continuously. Right? You can imagine me 6 o'clock. It's 8 o'clock in the night, 6 o'clock in the evening. So 6 in the morning, me wanna play sound system. I'm not a DJ now. Because then tell me, nobody know how you to pick up the mic. You want to announce
mm-hmm.
something, but talk about... That was the first sound coming, you know.
Yeah.
When I use them out, I go... It sounds good for me to see a record.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand? Tell them, man, start talk and things like that. But the time when you just announce, then next week, Saturday night, me a play a Philip Lane or whatsoever, I stood in time, come on.
Did you play in any clubs? You played any of the clubs? Like, I know back then there wasn't many places it was restricted. So you was restricted to the house parties, the blues dance type of vibe.
But well, did you get to play in any clubs? The only thing that was the one room. Sometimes we play in a one room, you know.
Mm.
One room. Because the man, some of the houses, they were drove my house.
Oh, okay. Right?
So you rent that room, eh?
Mm-hmm.
And see rent this room. The other man have a room upstairs and things like that. Say, well, a couple of shillings, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not keeping birthday party. And keep it in the one room.
Okay.
Because them times, you know, about so, when the one, them when me know come up after me, I only one box they have. So they can't play like in a two room, you know. Okay. They have to come back and back.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, well, I think it's just like I see that. It's not easy. It wasn't easy.
The struggles back then.
But you see, me not check it for that. Me say anything me have, me not want to borrow nothing from nobody. Anything from me have is mine.
Mm-hmm.
So me end up getting the 15 and the 12 inch from me have. So me have 2 boxes. Right? He also died. I'm going to make another little one take all the speaker under the house and jar, put in another plant. So we could have played in two rooms.
Okay.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So then they used to come, there was a man that used to come on, can do the whole lot of them.
Okay. And,
but me I play out, we can't give them in. You know what I mean?
Mm.
But anyway, the thing start to escalate, you know, the booming start really with reggae recording. 68, 69 forward coming. Because the one them behind that was the Rocksteady. Well, Rocksteady was in the 68. But anything behind that was, because the sound system in England, a pure instrumental we used to play on both sides. Because I'm going to tell you about the speed thing.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Pronunciation. We never reached that well equipped enough for that. You know, the guy that who can do it, you know, off key music and all that kind of thing. You know? So you find that if you take up that music and put it on it, and a man with no music, he said, what kind of rubbish is that? Because if you play all that record, you in good feel of come back and you dance for the rest of the time. Because you see, the way I think of you, and you play a certain tune, you know? But you see, me always pick my music to play. I have a selection of music, you know? We used to play for youth, white youth. We play for the Korean brothers.
Wow.
7 years me a play for them, you know.
Yeah,
the me a Neville in Chanta, right?
Mm-hmm.
Fishmongers, King's Head pub. As they pass near the police station, there's another pub down there, so. Guildford.
Okay.
When you go along southeast, when you go like Blackwall Tunnel, your branch shop, go down, what them car around there again?
Greenwich?
Hmm?
Greenwich? Greenwich, Deptford? Deptford and Greenwich?
Greenwich, man.
Greenwich.
Greenwich. Then you used to have a club around there called Club 99. The crew, them won it.
Okay.
Me go down there because never I play for them down that way.
Mm-hmm.
And me I play for them. But, you see, I never really noticed all them kind of things. But, a man who used to run the scene named Jerry. Massive Irishman, man. And Jerry used to come around there. And I listen to Wagwan, you know, my dance and Neville and all that folks. So him say he want me and them play this Wednesday. That's the first time I meet Chaka.
Okay.
First time I be with that man. Right? And I went down there. Because I during the week, I never tell none of them the posse they were carry boxes and things like that. We carry 3 boxes down there. Right? I'm going to have a sound string up inside there. Right? And when we go inside, they have a little stage. And we just put, they have a small TT-21. And they used to call it Bluebird. Bad, I met it. Val, you know, TT-21. At them time, they appear at TT-21, give you one is 200 watt, two is 400 watt. We had 69. You know, when they play, it's like Bellman.
Yeah.
They sound like Bellman. distinction, you know,
yeah.
You can hear every word.
Chris.
Before I go further, you know me play music in England, a man cry, stand up in front of a man cry.
Yeah.
Take out money out of them pockets. I mean, I hear me man, you know, the one and give me money. I play for white people, you know, and them work on bending in the hall to that. And coaching. Yeah.
Okay.
Brighton, all over the place. So actually, the building up a sound system now, I saw quite a few documentaries come out of people talking. Well, I'm not saying well, them talk, what them feel like, what them want to say.
Yeah.
But then I say good, you know? Because sound system was very few. In the 70s days, when we played Reading and Blue, there were very few.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you see, you have a gun and you have a shot. You know, make no difference. You understand?
Yeah.
You have you better have the record. Record worth more than gold. Mm-hmm. You wanna hear me?
Mitchell, let me ask you a quick question. Who created the sound of reggae music to you?
Who
created reggae music? Who took it from ska to reggae? Because
well, this guy I'm telling you, he was the only one that I knew used to make records in Jamaica.
Yeah.
With Baba Motor and everything like that. Those records come out in 78. Because you know, I have a 45 record existing.
Okay.
It was our 78.
Mm-hmm.
You know what 78 make out of?
What?
Full shit.
Yeah.
Fall down, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Americans make it out of it. You know, they have a fall cool,
mm-hmm.
and then the feces then gather them,
mm-hmm.
And then process it, and mix it with charcoal.
Okay.
Yeah, man, that's mm-hmm. what makes 78 record. Mm-hmm. You understand? So, anyway, what happened over the years in England now with reggae records? You know? Cause the word reggae, somebody is saying to me, say, it's Jamaica. Bonnie, I hear Bonnie, I say, man, what? I can't remember. There's a club in Dalston. They call it 007. Forest is down below.
Okay.
And Raspberry Place.
Mm-hmm.
Now you see that they build up a monument there right now.
Yeah.
Called Sir Collins Tower. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Right at Dalston Junction.
Yeah, I know it.
Now the man who them build up there now. You know. If I start to tell on things from the beginning, it's going to take me about 3 weeks. You know what I'm saying? Mm. So I'm just cutting these things as short as possible.
Sure,
okay? Now, Forest's Club is a club in Jamaica, you know.
Okay, didn't know this.
Huh? Yeah, the name Forest is.
Mm-hmm.
Of Red Gathering. So we brought that name from Jamaica, come here. A lot of people know that, but it's a type of aristocratic club, like, you know, right now.
Mm-hmm.
God is club, right up Bullring. Red Gallery. The club is just over there. They call it Forest. So anyway, you know Rich Record? Layton?
Mm-hmm.
You don't know Rich Record?
Whereabouts?
Well, Joe. Let me name there. Joe. I shouldn't tell you what this song is. The first gate. Well, they had a record shop around there.
Yeah.
The guy who used to fish on that, you know, the West End. You know, I don't know what he said. I'm not a girl, but I'm more than family, you know. You know? Mm-hmm. Not a white girl, but I'm more than family, running up and down, you know, girl up and stand, you know. And back to the prejudice, the police used to go down there and just harass black man, trying to see that lesson. I've been down to the Flamingo Club. And Princess Margaret was sitting there.
Okay.
Right? And Lion Milton was standing over there. But she had about six bodyguards. And she was sitting in the kind of Princess Margaret, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know? The same boy with the car, George Flame there. Oh man. You know, but back to the reggae scene.
Yeah.
Cause the reggae scene, you know, that record changed in about 20 different styles, you know. Cause if you listen to some of the reggae record, they are listening records. But me as a sound system man, you know, I know the type of rhythm to play for people to dance. That is something you have to know. Now, we all come from a place called the Caribbean. Our thing is what? Calypso music, don't it? It seems you know them called soca. It's a version of like reggae, but then do it in a calypso way, don't it?
Mm-hmm.
That is our music. Now, you have later still down in coming down in the 70s, they start to make what we call roots music. Right?
Yeah.
Things that were happening in Jamaica and things like that. But where you find more of the Rastaman music.
Yeah.
Right? When I play all in America and all them kind of things, there are certain nights I can play that record. Play those type of record. But when it break Saturday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we have to find a different set of record. Because even when we in a play in a Narek, right? All the song where you can know, get it. Like he wasn't around the circuit, because he couldn't come in at that time. Because he was kind of pop-up. And black and then we take over and things and things. Fat man, the lot of them, name them, Quaker City, cause we got a burn, you know, cause that's the only song in England that, you know, I'm not gonna say I respect him, but I beat him. I don't mean to beat him in a large margin. I was away above him.
Mm-hmm.
And he used to beat everyone where you know. When the sound leave from here, I'm going to burn it up. Because they used to set it up, the crickets used to mash up them daylight and send them come back. And then I talk. You know, when you go up there. Now I had a friend named Legs, Bill Amplify. He's gone to Long America years ago. He was one of them man that you heard about Kendall crash?
No.
With the train, you know, how much people there are back up. I mean, a Denby.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I hear about them. The man them do a cowboy thing there with the train going. He's a priest, Father Sherlock, the man name. Keep this out. And the boy them want to rob the thing. Same like how this is the Western business.
Mm-hmm.
And the man them pull the plug. You know, we join the coach them together.
Yeah.
Dead man. People that are Jamaica crush to dead man. That was one of the biggest disasters. Them do that to him. He was in it. He, if he come here, you know, you see right here, I can take my fist like that and push him out. I never know that a man's skull can sink
so far.
It's like, you know, you cut a ball, a rubber ball.
Yeah.
I say it wow. Like that. And then, but he lost him hip, he had problem with him hip, same walk, kind of, you know, good technician. I'm young, he used to work things like that, you know.
So
he used to come now, weekend time, don't come here with the sound, right? And they won't give me the news, they were quick, I do it, they were them. When they left from down, they go up there. I like the Coxson. He's like, kill Lady. He's like, kill Lady. Because he go up there, they make fight, you know.
Yeah.
And him. But some man make fight, you know. He couldn't go back to Burnham for about 11 years.
Yeah.
Lady.
Okay.
He couldn't put him foot up there and kill him. Yeah. His son couldn't play up there.
Metro, stick up in there for me a second. So, I know you were the first man to build a sound, but will you build, you build sound systems for other sounds in England?
Well,
can you name some of them sounds you build for, please?
Well, I can't remember. Yajax. What I call Chaka Kai, you know. Sir Biggs. It was a bad song, Harringay. One I call Jet Power. Admiral Ken. The Derek song in here, but I can't remember any other song now. I can't remember the man now. Well, in the beginning, a bit Fugitive. Scotty. But this man, he does so much of them.
Okay.
So much of them. Plenty of them. Maybe our 4K88 amplifier. And the guy as he built it, he went straight. This is from 70-71. He went straight to Jamaica. And we're gonna open business and it get burst. And when he come back to England, a Duke he'd buy the 4K88 after him.
Okay.
Cause instead of him go down here and really hear it, really watch it. Bad.
So Mitchell, would you agree if you say that it sounds
at Bristol. The whole of sound system in Bristol would be them man.
Yeah?
Yeah, Jacks, the whole lot of them.
Okay.
Birmingham, Sir Christopher. Whole of them, man. Whole lot of them. We can't remember them. We not talk about the little one, them. We talk about my substantial song.
Yeah.
Big song. But everybody wants to like Shaka. I see everybody wants to say. But you see,
You build Shaka song?
Yeah, man, we don't sound that from scratch. That's,
yeah?
That's what I'm going to say, the home meeting.
Okay.
Because when we done with them, done 99, you know. The crew, brother, them come out and stand up in the middle of the place with the whole part, get out white boy and white girl. And said to me, said, Mecha, don't play no more record, don't play no more record. So I said, because but from me, land on the thing, me have everybody mad enough, mad on the floor. You see, I'm somewhere where I shuffle and I do all that kind of thing. You can't believe it's a white man. You know?
Yeah.
So anyway, they just come out. Because it's like the hall, you know, and they have like a room or so.
Mm-hmm.
But the shelter, the top of it is like plastic. You can't see prospect. Anybody inside, you can't see them. When I got there, me never see one of them, you know. Me just string up and start playing, right? And when that time them inside, I watch everything what's going on. And when them see the crowd start getting mad, that's when we meet Chaka, man. Mm-hmm. We play a tune there, wake up, power! Straight down town. What? Just kept a rush fire, man. Right? I play this tune, African melody. This is Kalunda and Kenyatta. Pam, 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 pam. What? Because the white folks, them like Sky, you know?
Yeah.
You know? And we just put on a tune named Phoenix City. Pam, 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 Jesus Christ. The whole place get on fire. Jerry, just come out, man. Man, and that time, first time, I go see them with my eyes. I see them before, but nearby.
Yeah.
And him said, Macho, don't play another record. Because for me, go and start playing one. Never DJ, don't know how to play. So me, I want to say, you know, the resident, so I don't know how to play. But the way my thing was playing, man, and the music I'm going to play, then when we look right below the stage there, you know, we see a man stand up and I say, where you get the music there, sir? And that was Shaka.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And from that day, when we give him the address of my house, and thing and him come look. You know.
In the middle cell.
We bring one of the car and fire come up when it's 400 was I'm trying to fix it up.
Mm-hmm.
And then start to play. Well, and they have some friends like when they one of them, you know. And them say, no, I don't want to do, I have nothing to do with this thing, because certain things them are on bigger than that, you know?
Yeah.
So okay, let's take it up. I mean, just build a fire and give you with that one and start, man. But you see how little we build one amplifier, you know. It is empty, the valve amplifier. Why? It's a world beater, man.
Yes, yeah, because I'm crazy, yeah.
Because I'm telling you something, man. The frequency went drop them speaker down there, man. You know? And if I just drop them in the box, it come out, you know?
Mm.
It come out with a zing, yeah?
Mm. So you're responsible for the great Shaka sound, that great quality that Shaka. Shaka's an institution in sound system.
Well, I'm trying to because my name is what it called, but my attitude is when you hear Shaka, I mean, nobody is different from the other one.
Mm-hmm.
But If you have a tone about amplifier, it going to cost you a lot of money.
Mm.
If you have 500 watts, it's less. It depends on what you can afford.
Okay.
So that's the barrier there.
Mm.
You know, and I say everybody would want 1,000,000 watts. But how much it going to cost to make? You know what I mean?
So Mitchell, you see, I'm gonna take it into a little direction here.
Mm-hmm.
Would you agree that it's the sound system, the sound system like what you created that made reggae music a global thing?
Well, it become a global thing. But in Jamaica, and why it come a global thing? Because we established reggae records right around the world globe.
Sorry. Let me stick a pin. I want to try the next question and make it answer at the same time. Did the BBC have anything to do with the promotion of reggae music
as well? That I can't explain to you. There used to be some guys used to go and do documentary from Jamaica,
mm-hmm.
and come back and establish. But there's a lot of drawback, you know, because I tell you the truth, you know, mm-hmm. you have a little fear. When the music started to take position, you know what I mean, because it was like a competition. Because you have the Americans making soul, the Englishman will make pop record and things like that, you know. But this music penetrate in the people more than reggae music penetrate than this music.
Yeah.
So you find out, say, if a man was going by that soul music there, you know, and he hear that reggae record, he would buy that reggae because there's a beat,
mm-hmm.
there's a vibes, you know.
Yeah.
That don't mean say the soul don't have a vibe, because if you like certain soul, you'll buy the soul.
Yeah.
But like the pop thing, was a different concept complete.
Yeah.
It have nothing at all to do with reggae record. The only thing about it, what went wrong, if we had a writer like Bob Marley had write his song, maybe things would be quite different. But most of the reggae records been adopted. You have other artists that make it in America. So, Jamaica artists, look upon the black artists in America to give them certain ideas, right? Because they were the singing bird. Right? Because all what's happening, you know, they created the black American. Right? Same state pick like we. Yeah? But hard life caused them to do a lot of things. Hard life caused them to do a lot of things. And, the segregation business in America and all that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But regular record, look upon the American record, soul life. Now, for instance, now, this record, they call Caught in the Light. I'll tell you about what, when I was going on that road. But when I got that record, I got it in a sub 78 record. I got 3 copies.
Yeah.
I get Jude win one, and Lyle Coxson get one. I said, only 3 person. And I say in the world, you know, in England, could be able to put him on that record.
Yeah.
Right? And that record is become so big because somebody sing it over. Where she named the sing it over?
Sylvia
Taylor. Lyle Coxson. Caught in a Lie.
Sylvia Teller.
Eh?
Sylvia Teller.
Eh?
Sylvia Teller. That.
No, no.
The girl?
No, we saw Caught in a Lie.
Louisa Marx.
Louisa Marx Caught in a Lie.
Yeah, Caught in a Lie. Yeah, she. Yeah, well, I gave Lie that copy of record. Okay? But that's good for him, you know, because I even. Send back that record that Jamaica and Moody make it, because there is another version to it, you know.
Yeah.
And Moody, that advice is on it. Well, that song is so good, you know. Man. Everybody look how we are. But the reggae music, as it comes down, they start to improvise with different sing, put that into that, and it sounds still the bass line is still there.
Yeah.
But on the other part, you have a whole lot of soul mix up in your head.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cause mostly like guitar music and things like that. Black people never really go for a lot of guitar music, you know.
True.
You know. It's when Jimi Hendrix started to establish himself, my man. You see a black man can maneuver a guitar like that. You know? Then Because we thought it was a white scene, because the whole band nice, they used to make it right, you know.
What's one of your most memorable moments in sound system? A sound that you beat, teach, something like this.
There's a night that I play in Birmingham. Mm-hmm. At a place called Wilson Green.
Okay.
Wilson Green, you heard about Birmingham Prison?
Yeah.
Wilson Green Prison. Mm-hmm. Where this venue is, like here, Wilson Green Prison just across the road.
Okay.
So, actually, when I'm playing in there, well, I don't know if anybody is, but it happened this particular night. And another song was playing inside here. And,
which song was that, bro?
I tried to remember the name. The name Zion.
Okay.
So named Zion. Yeah. And when I don't ramp, you know, I don't mess about when they come on to them kind of thing. You know, my thing have to be number one.
Yeah.
Because before I left my yard and go to play, me, I have to see that it's well done.
Mm.
Obstacles are there, but it's not my fault, you know. Well, Wilson Green, I was playing in Wilson Green.
Mm-hmm.
And while I was playing inside of the or something, because from my thing since Switzerland, you know, nobody has no one play. No, it's true. So I was there playing, and I was surprised to see how much people come up. Because it was a Sunday night, right? And I take over the amphor and I see the crowd and start to play some music. I've got two records, right?
Mm-hmm.
I never forgot them. Yeah, I heard about a record then called Obidiah.
By who?
Huh?
Which song?
Obidiah.
Obidiah? Yeah. Who sings that?
A guy named, like, in a name, Buccaneer.
Okay, yeah.
Right? And one they call Fig Root.
Okay.
You know, they might record an exclusive record, you know.
Okay.
Huh? And you know, I'm in the mood, you know, I'm going to turn up the sound and the sound starts to deliver. Like every place inside there, your stomach and all them things, they start to shake up, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And all of a sudden, yeah, big bum, you know, like somebody take a spade shovel and join on the ground.
Yeah.
And that was the guys, I mean, the prison.
Okay.
You know, the little wind that them, when them look at people,
yeah.
Them take something and draw against it like a great blah, 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 blah. Yeah, that was another one.
Mm-hmm.
That was a good inspiration.
Yeah.
But it ended up to be. And not very long after that, I stopped playing this song.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Why is that?
While we were there, four guys came from Brixton. Drove one of them big Mark 10 Jaguar car. But when he went up there to sell, because he was working with Tanai people, them, right?
Yeah.
So he could have get the diaphragm them from Tanner. The diaphragm is the tweeter.
Yeah.
The tweeter that goes into the Tanner speaker.
Mm-hmm.
right?
Tapping.
Them time there is about 18, 19 pounds for one day from me now.
Okay.
Well, the guy was working there and he got some. He got maybe about 50, 60 there from. But he was negotiating with the sound number and them for the man by them. So he drove from London to Brno. When he reached the brother yard, I don't call him name. When he reached the guy yard, the man, Mrs. said, he's not there. So the guy then walked to the left London, they didn't have any money in their pocket. So they were depending that when them sell the diaphragm to this man, they don't have money.
Yeah.
So when them got there, the guy went away. Whether he had the money to pay, I mean, I don't know what the reason, but I don't know. Right? So the guy them were lingering all over the place now. Them can't go back to London because them have money to buy petrol to go back.
Okay.
You know what I'm so when I come, when I reach the Wilson Green in night, they must get the news that I'm playing there because they were somewhere in Birmingham. And the Drew come up, he said, what petrol him have is just barely can come over.
Yeah.
So them coming at the dance and see the palaver and the people them are jump and things like that. He said to me, he said, why? He come up and he started to explain to me. You know. And I said to him, he said, why hungry? You know? So I said, you hungry? So he said, come on. I'll cry the four of them inside of the bar where the guy having drinks and curry goat.
Yeah.
We said to the man, said, sort them out, man, give them food. Huh? And the man, and I said, give them a food and a drink. Yeah. And me outside, and when wailing out the man, he got mad. You see all this jumping, when they jump, I said, I never do that in my dance plan, man, long time.
Okay.
Man, I jumped till all the men had to see it again. Anyway, we finished eating and then come out and he said to me, but the belly full, you know, and things like that, but we can't get back along, you know. And we don't have no juice. So we go back to the brother and we say, give me 20 pounds. The man will keep the dance, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I said, 20 pounds. And the other thing, we said, go buy some petrol. I think, what are the guy in the lot now? He had a girlfriend, like a couple of years before she had a kid. And him just slip away because then come with the intention to just come and go back.
Yeah.
Yeah? But he can't find this man to get no money from him. So he said to me, sir, why never go? Go to that petrol, go get some petrol, and we have to take time to go now. So I said to him, I said, wait for me, no man, you won't have a trouble to go now. He said, no, because the guy wants to make a phone call, and the work girl took him and went into the hospital, and him up there. Because he was worried now, say, she had left him and all them kind of thing. Because he's not supposed to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And come over with a friend, them, what he likes. I go into the car and say, may I go down the road and say, we'll soon come back. And never come back. But yeah, they drove a car. The man then take the 20 pounds and then go and say, all right, make sure you come on the phone me and things like that. Because one of them play flute in our band. And him just, the bag with the arm there from.
Yeah.
He just said to me, hold him, you know.
And just give you it just like that?
Yeah, he give me the whole, it's about 40 there from, man.
Wow.
40 there from, yeah.
Metro.
Sorry,
carry on.
They move on and go on with business, you know. We play a play call through a Sunday morning, you know, it was about 6:30.
Mm-hmm.
We say, I'm going to shut off, man. Don't do anything like that. I'm on the morning, can't carry on. And we say, watch, me not hanging about, we sleeping on a lorry to come down the motorway. So we load up one and we head into the motorway. When we come, I didn't pass Coventry roundabout. I'm coming on the other, yeah, some light with that colour along the motorway.
Yeah.
But when I look, I was driving, you know, everybody's sleeping in the bar, the lorry back, and Eddie have returned to him, and I'm not sleeping. When I'm looking at the street going in front of me, I see this tire mark. You know?
Mm.
But the tire mark is not an ordinary car. It's not. Because you know them jabber.
Mm.
But you can get certain vibes, you know. You know, everybody have a spirit. And I drove about like from here. So out in the street and I'm about to step on the brake. Because when I look in front of me, I don't see that everything clear.
Mm-hmm.
No breakdown, motor, car, or anything like that. But through the morning, a lot of dew. It wasn't raining, a lot of dew. And we come out, but I look at them in the lorry sleeping the same way.
Yeah.
And, I walk up telling me to see the mechanic tire mark coming off of the lane. I said, come. Like it'll make a circle. And head straight over the precipice.
Yeah.
When I climb the bank and look over, I saw Mr. the Jaguar car. In a tree, you know.
Yeah.
Cause truly the place nobody not really a lot of whiz and all them kind of tie up like, you know, a rope. But if him drop through the trees, a man drop to the bottom. Everybody dead. Mm. One man die.
No. And that was coming from that dance there.
You see that? Me and the police, I kept on street. Morning, noon, and night. So we have to tell you, nobody come back, they come, me, no, not now. We just come and see the scene and everything like that. And things like that. And about 2 weeks after that, I said something. There's concentrate making them fun. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Metro, listen, brother. We're running out of time. One thing I want you to do is, do you have any advice for anybody, all these up and coming sounds that's interested in building sound system and starting sound culture?
Well, building sound system, I don't have my time when I was just here. You never have nobody who can do that. Till a man named Jackson came from Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when Suckerby start build up sound system. But, you know, I'm not underestimating anybody. I don't beat anybody, I better beat them. But tricks in trade, everything that you do,
mm-hmm.
you see, me believe in this, and no man can take that. When you born, God give you certain things to do, and if you find the right thing to do, nobody can do it better than you.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yeah, definitely.
Nobody cannot do it better than
you. Mm-hmm.
Inspiration, you get that without anybody show you anything like that. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because I never have anybody say, well then, bam, 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 that. If I made a mistake, in that right thing, I have to stop them myself.
Okay. Yeah? So Mitchell, you told us enough about it. The vibes and where you come from and your sound system and memorable moments and you know you're a real champion of
well back in the electronics yes I was talking about like I was talking about electronics is you never stop learning you know
okay
that's the thing that you can never stop learning because you can experiment in a vast amount. The field is wide.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If you have certain ideas, which I was saying to you, color and arithmetic, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because all of these registers, you have to learn them. That when you see one, as you see it, you can identify if that is a 10 key or that is a 47 key. One meg is 1 million. Right? Now, I always explain that I teach a lot of these guys. Right? Well, the first year that they have to learn to read a register. If I said to you, I have 100 resistors inside of that box. I said, bring me 100 K. You have to know the color. You have to know the color of the resistor. How much band it consists, because the resistor have 4 band. Percentage.
Metro, sorry, let me stick up in there because you know what? Your knowledge is in depth and there's so much knowledge in one person, it's enough. So we're going to have to work on a part two. We have to come back and do this all over again and get more of you because your knowledge is extensive.
Well, let me tell you, not even the beginning, man.
Yeah, I'm telling you, just scratch the surface on some of it. There's one thing I'm going to really touch on before we leave out of here, because we was talking earlier on and you told us about a sound system called SINCLAIR in Jamaica.
Can
you just touch on that quickly before we get out of here?
Yeah, SINCLAIR, the thunderstorm. We come from, the guy actually came from Portland.
Okay.
Right? When I was leaving Jamaica, I've got certain record which I played that record until this time now and nobody heard it, anybody played.
Yeah.
It's near more what a smile can do. Right? It was made in a reggae record, you know. And he had that one tune. When he plays that, the whole Jamaica wake up, man. SINCLAIR, the thunderstorm, telling me anybody, tell it a Metro, tell him what. You see, all these song man, them man, I mean, all that, but they not know nothing about them kind of thing. They not know nothing about them kind of thing. No, the only guy know, and him do him know, because all them time they him never him there in Jamaica. And certain things, it was Vinny, you know? he's telling Buddy that he's the first sound system that actually came out. I'm not denying that. What him call sound system, I ain't not a sound system. Alright? One box, one little box, and one little amplifier can shake a sound from what a paper bag. That's not sound system. We had sound system in Jamaica.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
And my piano was,
So Mitchell, listen, I know you've got a thousand stories, like I said before. Your knowledge is extensive. But we're going to wrap this up and we're going to get a part two out of this. So, one thing before we leave. I heard that some of your knowledge is being put into words, into a book. Can you tell us a little bit about that book?
Chris, a book.
Yeah, about your life, about all that was happening. From you came over here, or it start, the story starts in Jamaica, to England, and your bill sound system.
From my left Jamaica.
That's good. What's the name of the book, my boy? You have a name for it, you have a title for it, yeah? There's no title, so it's still in the works. That's perfect.
Should I work? We're not making money for you.
Okay. So people, there we have it. Metro Downbeat. The creator, the originator of sound system in England. And this is a fact. You're hearing it from the horse's mouth. You understand? From the general's mouth. You know what I mean? And you know, there's so much to be said, there's so much to be spoken about. So we got to come back and we got to do a part two. Can we just scrape the surface of knowledge and information on our system? And it won't be fair to just leave it like it is. So, Metro, Downbeat, yeah. It's been an honor chatting to you today, sir.
Yeah,
man. And I just want to say thank you very much for myself, SINCLAIR, Reggae Vibes, you know what I mean? And all the people that's going to be watching this around the world, we want to say thank you. And I know people that's watching it now are saying thank you in advance from their hearts. You understand me?
Yeah.
So, thank you very much for being part of SINCLAIR and Reggae Vibes.
The story just begin, you know?
Yes.
The story just begin.
Mm-hmm.
And then come out for the ice.